22nd, Simon? Seconds. Seconds, Mark. Second. 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 Second, Mark. Seconds.
Thought about it.
Seconds. Seconds.
Seven or nine?
Nine.
Chalk. Score 2 to Damien.
Yeah, chalk. Drawing himself up.
Yeah.
seconds. Seconds, Tony.
I I
seconds. Seconds.
Thank you. Hey.
Is he? What's it on? You're on Fox Channel.
Seconds.
Thank you.
20 seconds.
Come on, mate.
Come on.
20 seconds.
Come on, mate.
Thank you.
okay.
Come on, Damo. Come on, Harry.
Come on, Mitchell.
Good job, Harry.
Up the three guys!
Hey, hey, hey,
hey, hey, hey, hey.
At home watching this on the
we've
been sending a message, mate.
Down my head doing
Oh,
set and say, congrats.
First champion of the event goes to Kenan Creek. Well done, Dane Harvey. Great performance. First class. And on the reserve table, it's four all in the race to five for coming out of the
world.
Good evening, Mark Wood here in commentary. Congratulations to Damien Ha, very worthy winner of the Masters singles title. Played well all week, Damien, as many people will know. Finished second in an Australian singles championship a number of years ago, so quite a quality player in his own right. We have a very tight finish to the reserve grade final. Playing here are the two Litchfield teammates, young Aidan Hodgson and Captain Kane Moller. And four each at this stage, race to five, so down to the wire in this one. That's not quite what Kane was going for there, but a very good result. Lots of work here to do for the Reds. Ball here in the bottom rails is going to give him a little bit of grief, but at the table now, which means he's in control of his own destiny. Just promoted a ball there, and I don't mind that. The couple of yellows tied up as well, so it's one of those games where neither player can really just go. a little bit of work to do here, either for reds or yellows. Kane's loaded up on that one. That's actually a pretty good result. You almost wonder here if Aiden's simply has to promote the red to cover the black. Although then, of course, then it's available elsewhere, so perhaps leave it where it is just to keep blocking those two yellows. That's a wonderful shot, actually. Very nice cueing. It's got right down behind this red. Its pockets have started to stick a little bit, but still quite generous. Setting, that's a pretty good result. I think if you're 4-1 up here, you'd go on the attack, but at 4-all... makes you stop and think. He had a bit of a crack there, but that's... Oh. Now the young fella has a chance to close it out. That's a big error, that is. This red near the black is going to give him some grief, but... if you can pot a ball and develop it is the ideal scenario. That way you keep your two shots and break it out. Alternatively, a break out at some stage and just go with one. Nice clip into the pocket. If this was me, I'd be developing it now. You don't want a situation where you lose your two shots and then you develop it. Very confident young player though, of course. Yeah, likes to back himself, and considering he could be about to win a singles final, you'd have to say he's made it work. Still with two, of course. I think he's screwing back here. And that's not bad. Tricky little shot, this. I'm looking at a rebound off the cushion into the black, which basically leaves both balls probably available to the same middle pocket, but we'll see what the result is. There is a fair bit that can go wrong here, but it could also work out just beautifully. And not a bad shot. He is going to have to play a huge black here though, either that or a huge red to get on it. I don't know the big screw back here because I reckon it's going straight at the pocket, middle pocket. Might be able to kick into the rail and come back. And that's unlucky. He was on that black. This is absolutely begging for a snooker here. Begging for a snooker. Either that or you try and finish, but... And that's quite an intelligent snooker in that he's left himself a situation where if he gets back to the table, he's now a really good chance to run, and he's really just left Aiden... You try and get out of this and miss, it's game over. One option is to try and sit the black on the red, but there's nothing easy here. I think he's using the rails to try and hit this red. Oh, and he's played an absolute cracking shot. Where are these guys in A grade when we need them? That was just ridiculous how good that was. And suddenly it's pressure back on the yellows. At least if you're Kane Moller here, you're at the table. I mean, it's basically, you've got one easy pot here, then you need two good shots to win. That's the way you got to look at it. Always a lot of pressure when the red's just sitting right over the hole like that and your opponent's waiting just to pounce if you do make the error. Oh, and that's a lovely touch. This has been a really quality finish from both players. I mean, it's really just a question of composure here. You run nice off the yellow, you tap the black in the middle, but will the pressure of a final count or not? And it has, I reckon. The awkward part about this is being so close to the ball, the cueing gets awkward. This is actually a way easier shot if you're even 3 or 4 centimetres back and you can just have a nice clean swing at it. This will actually be a quality shot if he gets it. I think he's studying to see if he can flick off and get it in the middle, and that's where he's going. This is going to need to be a fine flick. He's got it. And he's just avoided the top. Didn't see the whole match, but what a quality last frame. Back here at 10 a.m. tomorrow for the finals for the teams.
Blue, one of the best juniors, Aiden Hodgson, and the other.